Bubba loves kids. I think kids are our only future. I have two boys, Bubba Jr. and Little Bubba. Well, I had to name them something, and that kind of fits. You know, I do have two sons. One I'm going to put through college. One I'm going to put through a wall. My oldest boy is dumb as a ball of hair. I love him to death, but he's just dumb. He takes after his mama. This boy wakes up in a new world every day. He just, walks in at breakfast, sits down, introduces himself. Son, we know who you are. Sit down and eat. This boy was 17 years old before he discovered how to get that last little bite off a shish kebab without gagging himself. So we got him in the University of Florida. He's down there majoring in criminology. Hell, I think he'd make a good criminal. Came home his first semester with his report card. This is tough now. I mean, I'm paying for this. This ain't free public school no more. I am suffering from maltuition. He walks in there, his report card, said, "Hey, Daddy, here my report card. Had three F's and a D on it. Three F's a D." I said, "Son, you want to explain this report card?" He said, "Daddy, looks like I spent too much time on one subject." I said, "You tell me one thing positive about this report card." He said, "Well, I ain't cheating." Little Bubba, not much better. We raised Little Bubba with PMA, though. You know, this PMA, it was wonderful, this PMA stuff. Don't y'all do that to your kids. You know, we raised all that junk through the 70s and the 60s. We thought we was doing everything with positive mental attitude. Remember all that crap? If you don't have a good attitude, you're not going to succeed in life. Most of you today are politicians, you know. So it's just one of those things. I was a red-blooded American boy playing college football in the mid-1960s, 255 pounds of twisted steel and sex appeal. I was getting in all the trouble I could, and another great Mississippian came to our little town, one of them motivational speakers, and stood up there in front of 8,000 college students and said, "You become what you think about." I knew that was a lie. I went back to my dormitory room, checked to see if I was changing any. If that was true, I'd have wore a 44D cup. That's all I thought about. I never did become one. Scared me to death. But Little Bubba, we had to potty train him, you know. We got to do that. Get about 18 months old, we had to potty train him. Now, I was a good daddy. I changed diapers. I changed one diaper in my whole life. And I'll tell you what changing that diaper did for me. It broke me from biting my fingernails that day. I still look under every now and then and see if I got any under there. I became convinced that baby caca was half toxic waste and half Velcro. We tried everything to potty train Little Bubba. I bought them Pampers, went out and got a box of them Pampers and put them on him. Left it on him for a week. It said right there on the box, good for up to 34 pounds. The doctor said, You got to use positive mental attitude on this kid. When you put him on his little potty there, you know, and he, every time he does it right, you got to pick him up and just pat him on his little behind. And I love to do that. He had the cutest little behind he ever seen in the world. And I'd just pick him up. I'd go in and I'd put him down, and boy, he'd do it. And I'd pick him up, and I'd say, oh, good boy, good boy, good boy. And I'd just pat him, and he got to where he got the right idea. We got him some of these little jockey shorts and threw them diapers away, and he was so proud. Well, we was going to the ballpark one day to watch his older brother play baseball. Rites of passage are occurring here. He said, Daddy, I got to go to the bathroom. He can now go with me. He don't have to go with his mama. I am so proud. We're walking in the bathroom there, and there was a guy coming out of the stall with his pants all down around here, and little Bubba walked up behind him and pat him on the behind and said, good boy, good boy, good boy. Now, you can overdo this PMA stuff. You don't want to do that with your children. You know, kids today just have a rough time growing up. Peer pressure in my day would embarrass you for a day. If it's real bad, it might embarrass you for a couple of days. Peer pressure today with the kids that are living in the world we're living in will kill you. Go ahead and stick some of this up your nose. It won't bother you. They have heroes that we're sending them mixed messages with. I don't care. Everywhere I go, I talk about it. I think it's important. We had Elvis when I was a kid. Elvis, my mama would not let me go to Mississippi State Fair and see Elvis Presley because Elvis went a hummer, hummer, hummer. I know that don't look like Elvis did. Imagine the late Elvis. My mother told us if we went and watched that, we'd go to hell. We didn't go. I was married and had a kid before I ever saw the man at Mobile Municipal Auditorium. Same woman sitting watching television last Thanksgiving. Michael Jackson's up there. Now, my mother's some of the salt and the glue that holds this whole country together. One of them pioneer stock people that talks back to the television. Michael's up there singing, the kid is not my child. And she said, well, whose child is it anyway? I said, Mama, what are you doing? She said, I'm watching this. What is that? I said, Mama, that's Michael Jackson. He's the biggest rock star in the world. Signed a contract for $96 million with Sony Records. She said, that's a man? I said, yes, that's a man. She said, Lord God, that fellow make Pee Wee Herman look like Rambo. What is it with Michael? Michael is 36 years old. Don't you think it's about time he made a sexual preference? And I don't understand this thing about the older he gets, the higher his voice gets. Isn't there something backwards about that? Yeah. I mean, I don't understand that part. I mean, next year only dogs are going to be able to hear Michael. You'll be see some dog walking down the street going like this. What's wrong with that dog? He listening to Michael Jackson. Oh. It's different out there now. I remember Mick Jagger when he had little bitty lips. And I remember Paul McCartney when he was with a band called the Beatles. Kids today never heard of that. All they know about is wings. And I remember Michael Jackson when he was black. I mean, let's face it, I think Michael wants to be a blonde woman. He just ain't gonna quit. I just don't understand this thing, this hero thing out there. I tell people all the time something screwed up in this country. We got two kids in California that admitted in a court of law that they shot their parents with shotguns, loaded three more times, and continued to do so, and we can't convict them. Something is wrong with that. I don't understand this Magic Johnson thing. I tell people everywhere I go, I don't think Magic's a hero. Got out there and got AIDS, illicit lifestyle, doing all the things that he did. And we got AIDS and we called him a hero. You know, Pee Wee Herman sitting in a movie house in Sarasota, Florida, all by himself. Pee Wee ain't hurting nobody. Pee Wee ain't even hurting Pee Wee. We put Pee Wee in jail. Is there something wrong with that?